cleanse. I just don't use shampoo to do it. I'm like, people really think that I walk around with dirty curls? What? Let's just know. That's just no. Hey guys, it's Alyssa Marie here. Welcome back to my channel. Before we get started today, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel just to make sure that y'all don't miss any future videos that come out. Just do it right now. You won't regret it. So I want to talk about something that is a slightly controversial topic in the natural hair community. Like, I feel like shampoos, you're either with them or you're against them. There's like no in between. And let's just get this out the way. I do not walk around with dirty curls. I feel like every time I say that to someone, they're like, oh my God, you gotta cleanse your scalp. I cleanse. I cleanse religiously because I'm very, very particular about my curls and I like to make sure they're super healthy. Y'all know how I do. But I just don't use shampoo to do that. So yeah, in this video, I'm gonna cover the reason why I don't use shampoo and then also some alternatives to shampoo that are like my favorite products ever. All right, so the decision to not use shampoo was a decision I made like super, super early on in my natural hair journey. My natural hair journey started off kind of weird. I actually wasn't sure that I wanted to go natural, but I obviously ended up going natural. The plan initially was to just see how long I could go without relaxer. Then I was like, all right, let's just see if I can transition to natural hair. And then boom, your girl big chopped. Right as I was getting ready to do my big chop, I would say like a week or two before, I started doing lots and lots of research. I wanted to make sure that my curls were as healthy as possible. In order to do that, I had to educate myself and just get prepared with the right products, the right styling tools, etc., etc. So among all of my research and my preparation for my big chop, I was gifted this book by a fellow naturalista. This is the Curly Girl Handbook. I like live and die by this book. I love it so much. This was written by Lorraine Massey. She's one of the founders of Deva Curl, which is a brand I also love. Basically, in this book is where I learned the truth about shampoos. And so now I'm gonna share that truth with you. So I'm just gonna read a little teensy snippet from this book. So it says, most people don't think twice about applying shampoo to the priceless fiber that's sitting on top their head. The problem is that they contain a dirty little secret. They have harsh detergents such as sodium, lauryl sulfates, ammonium, blah, 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 big words, complicated, which are foaming agents found in dishwashing liquid and laundry detergent. That detergent agent that makes it lather up, makes it nice and soapy and all of that, that is the reason why shampoo is bad. They're super, super stripping and drying for curly hair. They just strip your hair of all the natural oils that it needs in order to stay moisturized and healthy. When you're just continuously every week just shampooing over and over and over again, you get dry, frizzy curls, which then turns into breakage, which then turns into like a major meltdown in the bathroom, and then you're back to either straightening your hair or like going back to relaxer, and that's not what we want. So when I read this in the book, getting ready for my big chop, I was like, wow, that is crazy. Like, most people don't even know that about shampoo. Like, to me, all my life, as with my relaxed hair, I would just shampoo regularly every week. It's just a part of society. Like, you shampoo and you condition your hair. There is never ever a thought in my mind like, like, I wonder what's in this. Like, is this actually helpful to my curls? So basically that is why I decided not to use shampoo. I just really, really wanted to make sure that I loved my curls, and in order to love my curls, I knew I needed them to be healthy. There is nothing more frustrating than unhealthy, frizzy curls that are just not behaving, and I knew that if I really, really took the time out to just try in every possible way to make my curls as healthy as possible, I knew that we would flourish all together as one being. We'd flourish. So the book definitely gets way more in depth on telling you more about shampoo and all of that stuff. So if you're interested in actually reading the entire book, I 100%, like 10 out of 10 recommend. So I'll go ahead and link it below in the description box so you can go and check that out. So yeah, that is why. Now, like I said in the beginning, your girl
still cleanses.
The negative effects of using shampoo is like equal to the negative effects of never cleansing your hair. Never cleansing your hair is probably even worse. Like, that is just, no. So you have probably heard all about the whole co-washing cleanse. Co-wash is pretty much just washing your hair with conditioner. There are a range of conditioning cleansers out there that you can try, and I have three of my favorites here that I'm gonna go ahead and share with you. So first, what I use on a daily, not on a daily, that's a lie, on a weekly basis is my Deva Curl No Poo Original. I love this. I actually used to use the Deva Curl Super Curly No Poo, which is the Decadence, I believe, but I then discovered the Original and I love it so much better. So if you are trying to decide between the two, I would definitely recommend the Original. The reason is because, one, it smells a whole lot better, and two, it's got like this minty, tingly kind of vibe. It feels so good on the scalp. So this cleanses your scalp as well as your curls, and honestly, it can, like, your first time using a co-wash or a conditioning cleanser, it's gonna feel a little bit weird because you're gonna be so accustomed to that lather, and you know, that's how you kind of feel like, yes, it's clean. It doesn't lather at all, so don't think that, oh, this is like, it's not working, if it's not lathering, the whole point of it is to not lather. Once this washes out of your hair, it feels clean. You get that, like, that clean feeling in your curls, and like they snap back into shape, all the buildup is gone, and we're ready to style again. Another co-wash that I absolutely love is by As I Am, and this is their Coconut Co-Wash. This is really nice as well. So in comparing this to the Deva Curl No Poo, this is a lot more creamy, and it feels a lot more like conditionery, if that makes sense. Moisturizing is probably the better word to use. But yes, this feels so creamy and delicious in your curls. It is amazing. It has a lot more slip than the No Poo does as well. Same thing with this. As you wash it out, you get that cleansing feeling. Again, it does not lather. It really just feels super, super conditioning in the curl. So this one's really nice. I kind of reach for this one when I feel like my hair is going through like a dry spell or like a rough patch, you know? Versus like on a more regular weekly basis, I definitely go for my No Poo. Alright, so those are my co-washes. There's also one more very special product that I want to share with you guys, and this is something that I definitely don't use on a weekly basis, but something that I would use more bi-weekly or even sometimes just monthly. So this is the Deva Curl Buildup Buster. This is actually a micellar water cleansing serum. So I know y'all have heard of those micellar water makeup removers now. It's meant to help remove makeup but be a lot more gentle and easy, less stripping to the skin. It's this same kind of technology that's inside this bad boy that cleanses your hair without being too harsh and too stripping to your hair. So the micellar water is great because although it's very gentle, it is very, very effective for a super deep cleanse. So this being called the Buildup Buster is exactly what it does. Whenever I feel like my scalp is maybe a little bit more itchy, or like I said, bi-weekly or monthly, I will definitely go in with my Buildup Buster in place of my co-wash and get like a super, super deep cleanse for my curls and my scalp. So this also doesn't lather like shampoo, but it does, like, it's a way more intense clean than the co-wash. Like this, you have to deep condition or do like a little treatment after you use this because your hair is super, super like squeaky clean. Not to say that the co-washes don't give you like a proper cleanse, because they definitely do, and you can feel that when you use it. This Buildup Buster is just another step, like it's a whole nother level of cleansing, which is why they tell you not to use this very often. You definitely shouldn't use it weekly. So those are my three go-to products when it comes to cleansing my hair. I kind of use them in a cute little rotation, you know. I'm really hoping that you guys are understanding and absorbing this information right now, because I just feel like this is such an important part of your natural hair journey. It's a very controversial topic, but everything I'm telling you here, I feel like it's the reason why, like a huge factor in the reason why my curls are so healthy and bouncy and just very, very easy to manage. I hope you found this useful and that you decided to take the no shampoo stance with me. If you are just trying it out, comment below. Let me know if it's made any difference in your curls. If you like this video, go ahead and give your girl a thumbs up. Also, don't forget to share this video with your other Naturalista friends that might find this useful as well. And if you haven't subscribed yet, I'm judging. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll catch you in the next one.